So the next debate section is going to be led by Dr. Subhashree Kaliyaperumal, who's going to be debating that Humphrey visual fields are the best. She's a professor and head of the Department of Ophthalmology, Jipmer, Pondicherry, and a very eminent surgeon. Let's hear from her.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for this opportunity. The topic for the debate is Humphrey visual fields are the best. So it's more important for this presentation. I have no financial interest. Talk about standard white-on-white perimetry, Humphrey is the name. It remains an invaluable tool for detecting and monitoring visual function loss of glaucoma, and it can predict the future risk of functional disability. Why is HFA considered the gold standard for visual field testing? Because it provides a comprehensive visual field assessment and ensures reliable results. It compares patients' data to age-matched populations. It distinguishes focal from diffuse visual loss, can be used for patients who are wheelchair-bound, hearing-impaired, those with postural and fixation problems, and those with low visual acuity. And most important of it all, it is simple for the examiner to perform and interpret. There are other white-on-white perimetry, such as octopus and perimetry that utilize other technologies such as SWAP, which is blue on yellow perimetry, frequency doubling, high pass resolution, and flicker perimetry. Among white-on-white, YHFA scores, it's one of the oldest and time-tested perimeters. There are actually studies comparing HFA versus and octopus. The sensitivity has found to be almost similar, but HFA has been extensively well evaluated. Studies exist on HFA. There are long-term data available. And if you see the landmark studies, the early manifest glaucoma trial, the collaborative initial glaucoma trial, and the collaborative normal tension glaucoma treatment study, all of these have incorporated HFA in their visual field analysis. And if you see the popular criteria of Anderson's, the HPA classification of severity of glaucoma are all based on the Humphrey visual fields. And to top it all, it's very user-friendly with the advent of the CETA strategy. Detecting progression continues to be a challenging task in glaucoma practice, and Humphrey scores there too. The guided progression analysis, or the GPA on the HFA, allows trend-based analysis of the global measures such as mean deviation or the visual field index, and also the point-wise event-based analysis. Are they fast enough? Yes, the new HFA 3 has a CETA faster strategy, which allows the patient to complete the test in less than 3 minutes. If you see this picture, you can see the evolution of the HFA over the last 50 years. The CETA was introduced in 1997, and you can see the GPA was introduced in 2003. The HFA 3 has a very streamlined and faster workflow with so many new features, with the reduced visual field testing time. As you can see in the CETA faster, which is about half the testing time of CETA standard, and 70% of the CETA fast, but having the same reproducibility as CETA fast. So this improves patient satisfaction and reduces fatigue. The mixed GPA allows intermixing of the CETA standard, CETA fast, and CETA faster protocols, and you get a progression. There are other features like the exclusive gaze tracking and the liquid lens technology, which allows to load automatically patient's refractive correction based on the previous exam. Then there is a REL eye monitoring, which is a video capture feature that records images of the patient's eye during the presentation of each stimulus, and it helps to identify unreliable fields. And then there is the kinetic perimetry, which is more extensive in the new HFE3, and there is also the forum glaucoma work. Medical software by which the clinician can just acquire both the visual field data and the OCT data and have it in one place, And by this method, you can actually you can bring all the data, you can work from a remote computer and get all the, not only view them, but also you can manipulate the data. And you also have the combined report where there's an integration of structure and function. And this will allow, will tell us the anatomical relationship of the visual field points. The visual field testing by head mount and other tablet forms, they are all low cost methods, which will, and they're portable devices, which helps in the screening programs. But can they be used as a standalone screening test is a big question. The sensitivity and specificity of these tests for glaucoma detection, they remain insufficient. They are not enough data as of now. And so I would like to conclude by telling that HFA at the moment will continue to be the gold standard against which any new technology will be compared. Thank you.
Dr. Shalini, could you share your screen? Thank you very much, Dr. Suhasini, for a very extensive talk.